You talk about going out to LA and hooking up with Eazy-E. What do you remember about your early meetings with Eazy-E and auditioning for him? What was that time period like?
I mean, it was like a dream, man. See, people got to remember, we met Eazy-E at the end of 1993. And by June 1994, our EP Creeping on the Come Up was out. So when we met Eazy-E, it was still being some kids from Cleveland to see somebody that was famous and, very big prestige in the industry and things like that. It was like, that was like, it was awe. It was amazing. It was incredible. It was like, that wasn't supposed to happen to some young kids from Cleveland. You know what I mean? But
Yeah. What do you remember about your first ever meeting with Easy?
I remember, man, when we first we talked to him on the phone, and then we went to Cleveland to try to open up for Eazy-E, and he didn't see our performance, and that drove me to bum rush backstage. Busy and I, we went backstage and we ran into Eazy-E and we rapped for him, and it was like 100 people there trying to audition for Eazy-E. And he remembered us from the phone conversation. And when we rapped for him that day, the main thing I kept thinking was, this guy is really, really short. You feel me? Like it was amazing to see a person so little with that much power. You know? And the rest was history from that day, man. So I remember him being a super cool, down to earth, humble guy that kept his word, man. And I only got the pleasure to be with him from the end of 93 to the middle of 95. That was as long as I got to know him before he passed. And the memories I have of him was just like, he was the first down to earth famous person that I met. He was the first famous person that I met and got to know. But being down to earth, that was a real, real rare characteristic that it's still hard to find this day.